Hey, Cancer, what's going on? It's Deb with Goddess of Montero. I hope that you guys are doing well. I hope that this reading finds you safe. I'll go ahead and shuffle up the deck and we'll get started. Shout out to all of my new Soul Tribe members out there. I see you guys coming in. I appreciate the love and support, all the comments. Also, if you guys are new here, please don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, share, hit the post notification bell on your way out. I would appreciate the energy exchange. I don't know if you guys can hear the music in the background, but I got some music playing in the background. The Knight of Wands. Okay. So, Cancer, I think that you want a little excitement in your life right now. I feel like you might be kind of bored. So you might be looking to just have a little fun. You might be interested in a fire sign, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries, possibly. What's this? We got the King of Chalice or King of Cups, the Nine of Swords, the Queen of Wands, and the Two of Swords. Those wanted to pop out before I even pulled that. So you guys take that in mind because I feel like it might be some interesting energy coming in because somebody feels worried, possibly. And that's your King of Cups is your energy, Cancer. So let's see what's at the bottom. Oh yeah, the Tower. Okay. So that was in the middle of the deck, but what's going on? The middle and the bottom. So let's see what's up. Yeah, I feel like somebody, you might be worried, Cancer, if I'm talking to Cancer that might be worried, or someone is worried about you, Cancer, because you might be in this like Knight of Wands type feeling energy. You kind of just want to have fun. You don't really want anything stable, you know. But so the first card we got is the Ten of Wands, the Queen of Discs, the Hermit, the Nine of Cups, the Eight of Swords, the Five of Swords, and the High Priestess. Okay. So, Cancer, there is a heavy burden that might be, you might feel that there's a heavy burden that's weighing on you. Or you might feel like there's a lot of people seeking for your energy, possibly, you know what I'm saying? But it's also a lot of choices when it comes to finances. I feel like you're getting financially blessed. You're seeing a lot of opportunities when it comes to finances. So that's dope. I feel like you kind of just want to stay to yourself, though, but you also want to have a good time on your own. So basically you want to do things the way that you want to do it. Like I don't feel like Cancer wants to abide by anyone's rules per se. You know what I'm saying? They kind of just want to be free. They've been studying themselves. They've been learning things about themselves. They've been learning who they truly are. And Cancer, Nine of Cups. You know what I'm saying? Going after that wish, going after what you see as what you want for your life. Okay. We got the Eight of Swords here. So I feel like someone around you, Cancer, feels like they are stuck in their minds or they might actually be locked up. Okay. And this person has, the Five of Swords around them, so that means that they have people that are either fighting with them or like trying to start fights with them, trying to hurt them, harm them possibly. And then we got the high priestess here. So, I mean, I feel like this person might know that you might be the high priestess, you know what I'm saying? But if not, that someone is coming towards this high priestess energy. Y'all can see, I wonder if y'all can see the cards like I can, because the light is a little different. Okay. So what's the Ten of Wands for Cancer? I think you're really kind of just about money, and you know what I'm saying? You probably have fun here and there, but it's to whatever, you know, what you want to do, you know what I'm saying? The Five of Chalice. Yeah, the Queen of Pentacles reversed. The Ten of Wands. And the Hermit. Dang, so the ten, okay, so the Ten of Wands, y'all know that that's the way to confirm when I be getting cards like this, because I get them all the time. If y'all are OGs and y'all been watching me for a minute now, you know that this happens all the time. So basically, someone, it might be a Capricorn, Taurus, or a Virgo, Cancer, this person is not doing well financially. It could be a mother or an aunt or someone maybe you looked up to, because the Queen of Pentacles is usually someone who is stable, but when they're reversed, that means that this person is not doing well. And it's unusual for the Queen of Pentacles to not be doing well. So I feel like this person is carrying a heavy burden, because either they're not doing well because of the Ten of Wands. Can mean someone was a gossiper. Maybe they said a lot of things. Like when I see the Ten of Wands, because that's included in the Eight of Wands, maybe they said things about people's paths, people's journeys, like, and now all that has come back onto them. So now they're carrying this. They got 20 wands. So whoever this person was, they probably did a lot of talking, and now stuff is coming back to them. And it's like a burden to this person, because they can't get what they need. Because whoever it is that they need to talk to, or whoever it is they need help from, is in hermit mode. And I think it's you, Cancer. Because you're the Queen of Pentacles. You're the Queen of Discs in actuality right now. So you're on your high horse, basically, what I'm feeling. See? The Five of Cups is at the bottom. So this person, this Queen of Pentacles, is probably like very sad and very regretful. I don't know what they did, if it was a mother or you know somebody that you looked up to, if they betrayed you or they did something. I feel like they possibly did. They gave you some type of heavy burden. They made you feel like you had to do too much, basically. And now this person is feeling what they gave you. Okay, because this could have been a lifetime of stuff that added up. 20 wands. Okay, so the Queen of this, yeah, 20 years or more. Wow. The Four of this at the bottom. So, Cancer, we got the Queen of Chalice reversed. That's you. The King of Wands reversed. The Five of Pentacles. The Two of Pentacles. And the Three of Pentacles. Cancer, I don't feel like you really care. Because the Queen of Chalice reversed is like you have no feelings or emotions towards how this person feels, you being in hermit, because I feel like you're the hermit. Virgo, you might have Virgo somewhere highly aspected in your chart. Okay, but I feel like you also have this fire sign. Remember at the beginning I was telling you that there was a fire sign that was after you. This same person, this King of Wands, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries, feels like you have reject either you've rejected them or you're not interested in them the way that they're interested in you, because they're reverse right now. So this person feels left out also. So far we got a family member that feels left out, and then we have they could have been a lover. I don't know for sure, but this fire sign. And then we got the two of pentacles. So you must have been, when you were dealing with this person, maybe you were juggling or maybe they were juggling when it came to some type of third party situation. So maybe you, this was a person you worked with or someone that you did some type of business with, or you made some type of money with. Because we got the four of pentacles. So it's like you're hurt, holding back from this person. You're in hermit on they butts too, look, I almost say. I'm trying to keep it clean on this channel. We got two hermits, okay? That's all I got to say is, Cancer, I don't see your energy, and when you show up, this is how you show up. Like, no, I'm gone. I'm out the picture. I'm done. I'm focused on the nine of cups. But let's get the. I'm going to go ahead of myself. Let's get the hermit. Let's get the hermit. I feel like neither one of these people that you're letting go of, Cancer, was really helping you along your journey. I mean, they were, they gave you a lesson to not deal with people like that, but besides that, you pretty much have learned because you're the hermit, you learned. So, Eight of Wands. Yeah, look. Ace of Chalice. You like, look, I have self-love. I have love that overflows from the divine because I see myself. I see my value. I see my worth. I love myself. This is the Ace of Chalice is all in all. Like you're full right now. That's what you have to say. So you like, if I am the Ace of Chalice, I just need the nine to make the ten. I just need that wish. That's what I need. Because I'm already fooling myself. And I just need this nine to make my wish. Okay. What's going on with the nine? Oh, yep, that's what I'm talking about. Okay, Taurus energy in the building. Okay, we got Taurus in the building. Let's see what's going on. Okay, what's at the bottom? Because I ain't seen it. Ooh, the Seven of Swords. Okay. So we got the Hierophant right here. I feel like this is not, if this is your wish, okay, I'm just talking to the Cancers that made a wish of getting some type of commitment or getting something, like they want to stabilize something. I feel like right now, if you want to get married or do something like that, it's probably not a good time to do it because we got the Seven of Swords right here. So that means that stuff might not be as official as you think it is, or it's not, stuff is not going to turn out how you want it to turn out. Stuff might fall through. It's just not a good, you know what I'm saying? I'm not seeing it as a somebody deceptive or sneaky. I'm seeing it as like things falling through, or you know, you thinking things are going one way and then find out later on down the road that it's not going to go the way that you anticipated it. Because the 10, I almost say 10 because when I say this card, it's like a stabilizing something for 10 or more years. That's what you've been asking for. You've been asking for maybe a business or, like I said, a marriage, something like that, lawfully. But I don't know. Because we got the Eight of Swords right here. What's this? Somebody wants to, but they, I feel like it was an opportunity and they missed it. But let's see. Y'all see all these cards flying? Five of Wands. Yes, sir. It could have been someone that wanted an opportunity with you, and You know what I'm saying? Or just like, no, you're sneaky and I don't trust it. You know what I'm saying? That could be the case too. You know what I'm saying? It could be someone's wish. This could not be your wish. This could be someone else's. But let's keep going. Okay, let's keep on going, y'all. We got the six of this, the ten of this, the knave of this, or pentacles. I'm saying this, but they're the same thing. The Empress card in reverse, the five of chalice, and the eight of wands. And then I showed you guys the bottom, right? Five of wands. Yeah, conflict, fighting. Somebody's just, okay, I'm gonna show y'all these cards real quick. Five, five, and then we have five at the bottom. Five, five, five. Somebody needs to change the way that they're seeing life and their outlook. And, it's a group. It's not just one person, okay? It's a group. There's a group of people. But besides that, there's somebody that's confined in their mind. They're either locked up or this person is out here going in circles. Like, they don't know where to go, what to do, where to start, basically. They're conflicted because they're trying to get someone to work with them evenly, fairly, just, so that they could get the Ten of Pentacles. But this is the only thing that coming across is the Knave of Pentacles energy. I feel like this person already knows that that's not going to be fruitful. I feel like this person feels like that compromises their energy, Cancer. If this is you, you feel like dealing with someone that's a Knave of Pentacles versus your, you know, you trying to get to the 10 and it's like putting yourself down, your value down, or below your standards, okay? I feel like because of that, someone feels regretful because maybe they were supposed to communicate, but the only thing that they did communicate was a lot of harsh communication. Like, they maybe talked bad about you or said some messed up stuff, even probably behind your back, or, you know what I'm saying, to other people. What's the Five of Swords? Four Pentacles. Ooh. These people, these Five of Swords, people that were talking about you and all that stuff, they didn't see that you had this much strength, Cancer. The strength card, Leo energy. Okay. They didn't see that you were going to hold back. They didn't see that you were going to use your intuition with the High Priestess. So you are the High Priestess. Okay. What's the High Priestess card? They thought you were going to fight with them, Cancer. They thought that you were going to go to their lower level, okay? Judgment. You caught judgment on them. This is the last card. Yeah. Your intuition caused judgment on this situation. So I feel like regardless of whatever they're talking about and saying about you, Cancer, you really don't care because you got the Ace of Chalice. You're in hermit mode. You're working towards getting your Ten of Pentacles. You're brave, very strong. I mean, your intuition is on point. The Hierophant is upright. Even though you don't want this commitment with this particular person, you do have opportunity to get in this wish because it's here. Okay. So that's all that I got. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. Oh, almost 20 minutes. If you guys did, please don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, share, hit the post notification bell on the way out, and I'll talk to you guys later. Deuces.